as you know, big boxing historian. Followed boxing since being this big, right? And I watch films from the 30s mainly, 40s, 50s. That's it. I'll have the odd 60s and 70s. Roberto Duran's my favourite fighter, for God's sake. But I mainly play me respects the 40s men. So speaking to you there, me and you and Tommy was having a chat in the bag, running on the spot, throwing a shot. Jack Johnson, if you watch him, this might be a bad interpretation, but I've got good feet for heavyweight, so I'll half show you what I mean. Johnson, for instance. You've got to pay a lot of homage to Johnson through what was known as the miraculous twists. Watch that. Compare it with today's fighters such as Canelo, Mayweather. They will have a shoulder roll. He's still going side to side. Difference is, Jack Johnson was a man 16 stone pulling it off. One of the best fighting technicians in heavyweight history. I'm not going to say Ali. Yeah, to be honest. Man is the GOAT. The greatest of all time. But for me, like, he wouldn't last 5 seconds with the old ones. He would not last. No disrespects and no harm. I'm 18 stone, I'm heavy, yeah? And all that nonsense. Get that away, yeah? Listen, no such a thing. Tyson 20 stone, man, dodging bullets up and down. Take no notice to that. Jersey Joe Wilcott. I have been, as you can tell with my feet now, I've put so much training into my feet. I've always had good feet, but I never got a chance to show them. Now my feet's alive and electric because I'm at a healthy weight. I feel good. I might not look it to the camera, but in my eyes, I feel well. So that's good enough for me. My criticism, there's me raspberry ripples. I like them. There you go. You ain't got to contend with them. You'll have to see them and you've got to get used to them, but there you go. But Jersey Joe Wilcott had a job of manipulating his opponents with these. Yeah? So what you do, he comes side to side, he stand here, he drop really low with his front lead hand, and he chuck either side of where your opponent goes. Boom, boom! Then he did. He done it with Joe Lewis. Joe Lewis had great balance, great feet. Joe Lewis would curl over, walk you down, boom, lovely jab. He'd look so short, boom, walk. How he manipulated Joe Lewis? Joe Lewis did beat him. But Jersey Joe was about 68 at the time. Yeah, he was a granddad. He had 28 grandchildren and 9 great grandchildren. He was an old, old guy. So what I'm replicating is, if you've got a man what can do that as a granddad, side to side, why can't I fight that as a young man? 14 miles in hobnail boots, ate well, slept well, no social medias, no nothing like that. Lived, ate, slept boxing. That's why it's called the golden era. Something that we'll never get again, something we'll never see again, and it's just gonna be, look, if you're a boxing historian, which I am, that's where you've gotta go back to. You've gotta follow your roots. These young'uns of today, they'll mention Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather, blah, blah, blah. Look, go back home, watch some Willie Pep. Go and watch some Emory Armstrong. Go and watch Ezra Charles, Sugar Ray Robinson. And tell me them men didn't pave the way of what this thing is today. Now listen, you've got YouTube sensations now coming in thinking they can do what them men did. Them men was heavy here to see this. Men like the Raging Bull and people like that, they'd look in disgust. Men once fought and battled and hard, man, and destroyed themselves. Leather skin like that. And destroyed themselves for sport. To have some man come on, put his thing on. Oh, look, that's the YouTube man who eats the muffins. Get out of my sight, will you? Come out of it, man, will you? There's ever talk. Nonsense. Get out of it. What are you doing in that ring? If they want to be professional boxers, then fight professional men, then. You won't want to do it much, then. You won't want to know boxing, then. You won't want to know boxing at all. So if you want to play boxing, forget all your YouTube stars, forget all that nonsense. Come and have a go. Properly in a professional boxing ring with professional boxing fighters. Then we'll see what it is then, won't we? Someone who actually lives, eats, sleeps and breathes it. Like poor lads there in Liverpool, Manchester, down here. Young pros, what's getting left with hundreds and hundreds of tickets trying to sell them. And yous are there making a big mockery on it, laughing on weigh-ins, joking about lads, what's that thing in the face where they can't eat the day before the weigh-in like that. Tired, ill, starving. Yeah? Big heavyweight man taking lumps off each other's brains. Bang! Each shot for your entertainment. It's like, we're like the gladiators. Are you not entertained? That's what it is. And that's the truth of it. And I know I've gone on a bit of a rant, but YouTubers and me is a definite no-no. Get in the real world, get in what the actual facts of what boxing is. And it's for boxing people, not YouTube stars. You know, I fight any YouTube star born from his mother. No problem at all. YouTube stars. Oh, they just make me sick.